Greetings, internet travelers. The infamous BT here. And I'm going to be bringing you a different kind of video today. Real talk. Now, as you guys know, I'm not really one of those commentators that like to talk about anything other than the gameplay or video games in general, just because I'm not very comfortable with it. I'm not very comfortable with sharing personal problems or whatever. I might bring it up very briefly, but in general, I don't like to do it. But in this video, I kind of want to do it because I kind of want to announce some future plans as well. You know, last night, I was feeling a little down. I don't know why. I just didn't feel very good. Maybe it was the medicine that I've been taking for my sickness this week. I had the flu as well as strep throat this week, so I've been very sick. That's why there hasn't been very many videos the past little while, I should say. I did upload a few yesterday, though, and you can check those out in the video description below if you want, if you missed them or whatever. But I wasn't feeling good last night, and I think the main reason I wasn't feeling good was because I was overthinking things. I was overthinking things way too much because, see, at this moment in time, I have plans to launch some new channels here on YouTube, some new endeavors, because I don't know why, but for whatever reason, these past 2 years, I guess, pretty much ever since I turned 21, I'm 23 now, but for these past 2 years, I've really wanted to just do as much as I possibly can while I'm young. I want to try so many different things and see if I can succeed in all these different things. I have a YouTube channel with 280,000 subscribers currently. That's a big deal to me. I mean, I accomplished that. I built this channel from the ground up, man. You know, I'm super proud of that. But there's more I want to accomplish. And because I built this channel and it is a relatively successful channel, I have that ability now because I have you guys here. You guys are my fans, you guys are my subscribers, and although some of you are vocal about your disdain or disapproval of some different things I like to try, a lot of you are supportive, the majority of you are supportive, even if you don't like it. That means a lot. That really does mean a lot because it inspires me to want to try new things and try different things. And I hope that it inspires you too. I mean, last night though, I was a little down because I was thinking about all these endeavors I wanted to try, and I was overthinking things to the point where I was getting discouraged about wanting to do them. And this happens a lot, and I'm not very sure why. I think it really is just me overthinking things and me being afraid of failure. Truthfully, a lot of people don't like to admit their fears. They don't like to admit their weaknesses, but that is a weakness for me. I'm afraid of failure. I'm afraid of trying something and failing. That's just, it just crushes the spirit so much. For example, you know, I want to make a new YouTube channel focusing on music, like music I make and stuff. But truthfully, I'm afraid of failing like at it. Not necessarily in the sense that I'm just flat out bad, because if I'm bad, then I think people will give me constructive criticism and I can work on it. But success, like not meeting my expectations success-wise with it, is very disheartening because there's really nothing you can do about that. I mean, when you really get down to it and think about it, success isn't, there's no guaranteed plan for success. There's no guaranteed plan for something to be popular. And it seems a lot like nowadays that if something is good, like if I release something really good, I mean, whether it's a video on here, music, a freaking movie, if I make a movie or something, it's not guaranteed that people will like it and appreciate it, which sounds weird, but it's not like the old days. In the old days, like, the best music was the most popular, and now you have stuff like Bieber being most popular, and that's clearly not the best music. I mean, I know that like it's all opinion and subjective, but you know, there's so much better stuff out there that doesn't get noticed, because it seems like people nowadays would rather... I mentioned this in an earlier commentary when I was bashing that Honey Boo Boo reality show, because it's crap. but it just seems like something happened where the good stuff isn't the most popular. It seems like it's just completely random what's popular nowadays. Like, you look at television and you have these amazing shows like Breaking Bad, Dexter. Just recently I started watching Prison Break. Really fantastic show. I like that a lot too. And then you have these terrible reality shows that are just as popular, like Keeping Up with the Kardashians, Jersey Shore, Here Comes Honey Boo Boo, reality show number 87 on MTV, whatever. And the reason I'm so disheartened is because for all these bad shows and for all these good shows that are popular, there's a lot more good things that just don't ever see the light of day. And it seems like negative attention is better than positive attention nowadays. Like, yeah, I can bash on Jersey Shore, Honey Boo Boo, but that's just going to give it more attention. Like, any attention is attention. You know, it's all good in the end, I suppose. But man, I don't know. I just don't want to try something, and the worst thing would have it, like, the worst thing would be to be good at it and then not get, like, the success I expect. I'm not talking, like, some kind of overnight fame, I'm all over MTV. I'm not talking about that at all. But, like, let's say I started a music channel or something. Like, if I could get 100,000 views, that would be my goal. Like, you know, a video. That would be amazing. Just 100,000 views. I don't think that's too much, or setting my expectations too high if it is good. But in the back of my mind, I know that if I made something, like, really bad, like something so bad that it's funny in a way, or something so bad that it gets hated on, it would be more popular. And then I have this problem of wanting to, or I have this conflict in my head of, do I compromise my art for more success, or do I just try to make the best thing I can possibly make and settle for, you know, that lack of success? And either way, I feel like I'm going to be defeated and I'm going to be down about it, because that's really what gets to me and what depresses me when I overthink things and think about things like that. But and you guys are probably already bored of this commentary, I don't know, you know, but that's how I feel. And it's a shame. Because it really does scare me, man. I'm scared to death to try new things, because I get so into wanting to do it, and then when I really start to ponder it, I get discouraged. And I need something to help me with that. You know, I need something to inspire me and say, hey, man, like, it doesn't matter. You know, none of that matters. Just try it anyway. Try it anyway, because it might not turn out the way you want it to, but eventually you realize even if somebody does, like, say things like that and inspires you, it's not going to change the reality of the situation. And that is really what gets me. If you guys understood this commentary, then you are fantastic, but, you know, I just don't want to fail, and I just don't want to be one of these people who compromises themselves for success. That's not who I am. But at the same time, I don't want to pour my heart and soul into something that's not going to get recognized. So I'm at this crossroads. Like, what do I do? What can I possibly do? It drives a man crazy. It really does. Like, if you want to accomplish something and you don't know how to accomplish it, it will drive you crazy if you're really passionate about it. And this is one of those things. This is truly one of those situations, because I don't want to just do like video game commentary. I mean, this is great. This is fun. I love doing this stuff. I love entertaining you guys. I love pwning noobs with my gold G36. You know what I mean? I love doing this stuff. I love getting on Pokemon and making you guys laugh with a funny playthrough. I love Wi-Fi battling. I love all this stuff relating to gaming. It's great, but I do want to set my sights higher because I feel like I've done almost all there is to do when it comes to this. I'm never going to stop, don't get me wrong. I don't think I'm ever going to stop doing these video game commentaries because I love them so much. But I want to push myself and try new things. And if you guys have any advice on what to do to make me not think the way I think, overthink things so much that I get discouraged because of how the world is and how the media is and how people are and what gets noticed and what doesn't, then please give them to me. But, you know, I'm running out of time here. If you guys watched this far into the video, you're a saint. I love you. Thank you for hearing me out, even though it was probably just confusing and rambling and stuff. But anyway, if you enjoyed it, leave a like rating if you want. And I want to give a quick shout out to the More Video Games channel. You can subscribe to that. It's a channel I kind of partnered up with. The link to that will be in the video description. And anyway, guys, hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you later.